Hello there folks, how are we doing? Today I'm going to show you how to dry hop your homebrew. Now it's time to make my bitter even hoppier. So what you do, you let you put your beer into the fermenter bucket, you add your yeast, you know, sugar and all that, let it ferment for a week or however, you know, depending on your temperature, and then once it stops bubbling, once the fermentation is completed, then it's time to dry hop with your hops. So what you got to do, I have one of those, what do they call them, mushing bags, something like that, and I've got some marbles in there to weigh the bag down. We're going to rinse it, get all this sanitizer solution off of it, and then we're going to put these hops into the bag. The marbles are already in there. Right, so let's do that. Right, so we got this. This has been here for, must be 7 hours. Yeah, it must be something like that. Now the marbles. Going to rinse it because you don't want your brew starting to taste like the sanitizing solution. It actually reminds me I need to get some more marble. Some people say that you don't need to weigh the bag down, but it makes sense really, because the last batch I did, the bag was half sticking out of the beer. And to be quite honest, I want the hops in the beer, not sort of half in, half out. So we put the marbles into the bag, if we can get them in there. So, should have done that really. Right then, I'm trying to think how to got a big pot. I'm trying to make it easier to get the hop. Whoops, forgot the bubbles in there. So maybe put the bag over the pot like this, and because I'm on my own, so I can't get someone to hold it open for the hops. I've got a bigger pot, but this should be all right. And we're gonna put the hops in, folks. Right. The thing I didn't do last time was I didn't break them up enough. I think you gotta make sure they're all, so that it can all get inside it, you know. I've got these bags from, I think it was Tesco's or something like that. So we can, so we want the juices to get in there, you know what I'm saying? We want the oils to come out into the beer to make it hoppy. And pour them in. I'm actually thinking that that might be enough, folks. I might use this to bitter up a beer and get some new hops, because they do smell a bit not as hoppy as they did. So I'll probably put that. I'll put them back in the freezer, and yeah, we'll just use these for now. Yeah, that's the plan of action, folks. Right, so let's go up to the brew. I put this bag on it just to make sure there's no drips, because I was a bit paranoid. It's got a heat belt on it, but I haven't used it. I hadn't needed it. It's been a constant 22 degrees. Right, so there's my bag of the marbles in it. And hopefully, it will sink when we put it in there. But people have worried about sort of contaminating it because of the CO2 layer that sits between the beer
and the lid will get disturbed, but apparently it should be alright. I've done this twice and it's been alright. So it stopped bubbling, fermentation stopped. You can see that if you push down, you can see the airlock going up. That means there's no more activity. So, right, we take the lid off. Just gently, we don't need to, because we're putting it back on, folks. That's it. There we go, there's the beer. Looks lovely, doesn't it? We put the bag in. Well, I might need to purchase some more marbles. No, I'm sure that will sink, because it's obviously it's all dry in between the hops. So put the lid back on, folks, and then leave that for, I don't know, another week, another 5 days, perhaps? Yeah, another 5 days, probably. I'll probably batch this on Thursday. So there you have it, folks. That's dry hopping for you. Thank you for watching. See you soon.